Yes, anybody is having doubt in this, the current entering node is positive, leaving node is negative. The magnitude in both the case, the magnitude is going to be same, but the sign is going to be different. Is this clear to is this clear to all of you? Any doubt in this? How to
No,
mark
sir.
voltage and with the direction of current? See, if the direction of current is given in a circuit, you have to use only that. If the current direction is not given in the circuit, you are free to assign your own current direction. Is that fine?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now see here, how to assign the direction of current. See, if you have a voltage source in your circuit, general assumption is this voltage is so voltage source is going to deliver current, right? So current will be always assumed to be flowing away from the source. If you have a single voltage source, the current is always assumed to flow away from the source. Assume here in this case, here I have seen the next example. I have two voltage sources, and there can be only one direction of current, right? There cannot be two currents flowing inside the same loop. So, whichever voltage source is stronger, from that current will flow. See, from 10 volt, current will be flowing like this. From 5 volt, actually, current will be flowing like this because we assume the current is going to be moving away from the voltage source. So there cannot be two currents in a circuit. So what is the effective direction of current we'll assume? It is going to be like this because always the stronger voltage source will have more preference. Is this logic clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? So what is the effective voltage in the circuit?
5 volts.
It is 5 because 10 and the two currents are opposing, so 10 minus 5 will be equal to 5. I will come on how to say how I am saying it as 10 minus 5. For now, understand that the effective current is only flowing away from 10 volt because 5 volt is less stronger compared to 10 volt. Okay, so these two are very, very important along with this direction of marking the potential. That is very, very important for solving your problems. Now comes resistance in series. This formula should be known to you. We'll try to, when resistance, you see here R1 to R3 resistance are going to be in series till Rn, say n resistance are in series. What is the effect of resistance on series? What is the conclusion we make when resistors are in series? What is the answer? What is the effective resistance?
R S is equal to R N plus R two plus R three up
Yes,
to
you are
R N
going to add
plus.
everything, correct? The effective resistance is going to be addition of all the resistances. Is everybody agree to this? When the resistors are in series, I am going to add all the resistance. That is going to be my equivalent resistance. Now we'll try to apply KVL to this. So you have a voltage source, I have n resistors, and current always flows away from the voltage source. So in series, what is the important thing to be observed is the current is going to be same. In series, current is same and voltage is different. The voltage will be split across all your resistors, R1 to Rn. Please understand this very, very carefully. When you have a lot of series connected elements, the current flowing through each element is going to be same. The voltage across each element is going to be different. And when you add all the voltages, it is going to be equivalent to the input voltage. So since the current is flowing this way, I am going to mark plus and minus. So entering node is positive, leaving node is negative. Entering node is positive, leaving. So I mark this for all the resistance R1 to Rn. The voltage across R1 is V1. Voltage across R2 is V2. So likewise, voltage across Rn is going to be Vn. So now I am going to apply. See, this is a loop. You have a loop here, correct? So I can apply KVL. So mostly in series, we'll apply KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. See, now listen very, very carefully. See, inside the battery, current is flowing from minus to plus, correct? So inside the battery, the current is flowing this way. So inside, when the current is flowing from minus to plus, we take it as plus. So the voltage is going to be V. See the resistance. Inside the resistance, the current is flowing from plus to minus. So when it flows from plus to minus, it is going to be minus. When it flows from plus to minus, it is going to be minus. When it flows from plus to minus, it's going to be minus. So when it flows from plus to minus, it's going to be minus. So Kirchhoff's voltage law says, add all the voltage, put that equal to zero. Any doubt in this logic, what I told? You are clear with this logic? This is what we are going to apply throughout the circuit. So be very clear on what I am teaching now. Should I
Yes,
want to repeat it again, or you're okay with it?
चाहिए।
Should I repeat or are you comfortable with that?
सर कैन यू रिपीट वन सेकंड सर।
See, listen, I have taken one voltage source and I have taken all the resistance in series. In series, what did I say? The same current is going to flow through all the resistances. So my current direction is known. Current direction, we always assume it is going to flow away from the voltage source. So current is going to flow this way. Okay, current is going to flow this way and come back to your source. So when current is entering, node is positive and leaving node is negative. So I mark plus minus for all the resistance. And voltage across R1 is going to be corresponding V1, V2, V3, etc. up to Vn. See, inside the battery, see, whenever the current is going to flow from minus to plus, we consider the sign of voltage as plus. When the current is going to flow from plus to minus, we consider the voltage sign as negative. This is the assumption I'm going to make. You can consider it even the reverse way, but I have considered this way because it is logically correct. Inside the battery, you see, current is flowing from where, which terminal to which terminal inside the battery? Inside the battery, current is flowing from where to where?
Negative to positive.
Negative to positive. What is the sign I have told you?
Positive.
Yes, so I have written here, see, V. But see, the first term in the equation, it is V. Now consider resistance R1. Current is flowing from plus to minus. Plus to minus means I have to use minus sign. So it is minus. Voltage across R1 is V1. Same way, plus to minus, minus. Voltage across R2 is V2. Plus to minus, voltage across R3 is V3, etc. Rn, you see, plus to minus, voltage across Rn is Vn. Minus Vn equal to 0. So I can write V is equal to, by bring all the negative terms to the other side, I can write V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4, etc. up to Vn. Is this application of KVL clear to everyone? See, follow this notation always. Current direction minus to plus, write the voltage as plus. Current direction plus to minus, write the voltage as minus. And where you should see this plus to minus and minus to plus? Inside the device, how the current is flowing. Battery means inside the battery. A resistor means inside the resistor. Current source means inside the current source. You have to see how the current is flowing. Polarity, minus to plus or plus to minus. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Am I making things clear? See, this should be very, very clear because we are going to apply this everywhere. So if you get wrong or if you get confused in this, it's not going to help you at all. And by Ohm's law, you know, V1 equal to I1 R1, V2 equal to I2 IR2, V3 is IR3. I make all the I's same because in series, you know, the same current is going to flow. So this is the expression you're applying Ohm's law. Now I'm taking I as common. So I'm writing all these resistance addition is going to be R equivalent. So V is equal to I into R equivalent, where R equivalent is going to be R1 plus R2 plus R3, etc. up to Rn. So I can simplify the circuit by a simple circuit having the same voltage source, having the same current, but I'm replacing all the resistance by R equivalent. And the polarity of voltage will be plus minus. Any doubt in series combination of resistors, how we are applying KVL?
No, sir.
No, sir.
It's clear, right? See, the basic sum will be clear, but as and when we slowly introduce some difficulty into the sums, you have to be very, very careful on doing it. Now, resistance in parallel. So, same way, you have voltage load and all resistance are going to be in parallel. And in parallel, voltage is going to be same and current is going to be splitting. I told you in the beginning class, all the appliances in your house are connected in parallel because even if one equipment is going to fail, it is not going to disturb your other equipment. So parallel means current is going to be different. The voltage is going to be same because you measure voltage across the device. So across R1, across R2, across R3, across Rn. So the voltage is going to be same. So, if you see these two things, you should be very, very clear. You should not get confused. In series, current is same, voltage is additive. In parallel, current is going to be additive, voltage is going to be same. The same voltage is going to appear across all the resistors, but the current is going to be additive in parallel circuit. Okay. So, since the current is additive, I'll be applying KCL. So, what is the incoming current? Incoming current is I1. And outgoing currents is going to be I1, I2, I3, etc. up to In. So I can write I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus etc. up to In. Simple law logic, summation of incoming current equal to summation of outgoing current. Incoming current means from your source. From my source, only one current is coming, but it is getting split as multiple currents, I1, I2, I3, etc. up to IN. Is this first line clear? How I'm applying KCL? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Please, others also respond. Many are not active on the call. So please, if you are clear with things, I'm very happy. Otherwise, if you have even a slightest amount of doubt, you are requested to ask immediately, because these basics, if you are not clear or if you are getting confused, it's going to be, subject is going to be very, very difficult. Okay, so IE is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, etc. up to IN. Now find the current. Again, we go for Ohm's law. I is equal to V by R. What is the voltage? V. What is the resistance? R1. And you see, everywhere I use V, because in parallel, voltage is going to be same. Only the current is going to be different. So I can take V outside, V into 1 by R1, 1 by R2, 1 by R3, etc. up to 1 by Rn. So I'm going to assume this bracket term as 1 by R equivalent. So I is equal to V by R equivalent. Or I can write 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, etc. up to 1 by Rn. And I told you in the class, beginning in the previous lecture, 1 by R is called as what? What is 1 by R called?
Conductance.
So I can write this equation as V equivalent equal to G1 plus G2 plus G3, etc. up to Gn. Okay. So you see here, in series, resistance gets added, correct? In parallel, conductance gets added. So if you have a parallel circuit, if we want to find the effective resistance, it is not advisable to go by this formula. So which formula is applied? Sorry for the network issues. I'm getting disconnected very frequently. Okay, sorry. So anybody is having doubts with the resistance in series and parallel configuration, it is okay, right? You're able to follow the resistance in series and parallel? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So which formula?
You have any doubts? Which formula?
We want to use the conductance formula or... resistance formula, sir. Parallel, sir.
Which parallel. One? Your wish. It's your wish.
Okay.
Mostly we'll use resistance formula, but even if you use conductance formula, you'll get the answer. Finally, after finding G equivalent, how will you find R equivalent? R equivalent is going to be 1 by G equivalent, correct? The same yes, thing. Sir. So anyone you can do. Anyone you can use. It's going to be, the answer is going to be same. So see the conclusion here. If the circuit has many series connected components, then computing resistance is easy, because you just need to add them. If the circuit has many parallelly connected components, computing conductance is easy, because I'm going to add the conductance. After adding everything, you know R is equal to 1 by V. You can find the resistance by this method also. Okay. So this is the observation on having multiple series and parallel resistances in our circuit. Now we'll see about voltage sources, what we are going to use in our circuit. So we are going to use mostly only two sources, voltage source and current source. The voltage source is going to provide AC or DC voltage. Current source is going to provide AC or DC current. Only two types of voltage and current. Two sources we are going to use, voltage and current source. This is the representation of voltage source. A voltage source will always have a series resistance RL. Okay, so remember, all voltage source means there will be always a series resistance RL. And this is DC means we'll be using plus minus. If it is AC means I'll be having this sign inside. I'll be flipping around and I'll be using a sine wave inside to indicate it's going to be an AC source. DC means I'll be just putting plus and minus. So in case, if you're going to simplify your circuit and going to find equivalent resistance, you have to short circuit your voltage source because the resistance of voltage source is going to be zero. So the resistance is zero means what is the condition I told you in the first class? Resistance is zero means what is the condition?
Current is infinite.
Resistance is zero means current is very high. Current is very high means it is going to be short circuited. So whenever you are going to have voltage source in your circuit, you are going to find the equivalent resistance. You have to short circuit your voltage source. Short circuit means just replace this voltage source by a wire. Okay, current source. When your voltage source, you have series resistance. Current is dual, right? So current source will have parallel resistance. And this is your current source representation, DC current source. AC current source means you will be having the sine wave along with the arrow mark. This is going to be your AC current source. Okay, DC current source means only arrow mark because there is no variation of a current source. And if it is AC means you will be having this notation. And whenever you are going to simplify your circuit, what you should do for current source? Any guess? What you should do for current source? What did we do for voltage source? If you are going to simplify the network, replace voltage source by?
Wire.
Wire or short circuit, right? We replace the voltage source by short circuit. So what should we do for voltage current source? The opposite.
Open circuit.
What is the opposite of short circuit?
Open circuit.
Yes, open circuit means just leave the circuit open, no connection. So will current flow inside an open circuit?
No.
Current will not flow inside open circuit because current always requires a closed path for flowing. It cannot flow in an open circuit. Okay. So this is going to be your voltage source and current source.
Yes. Sir, why are we doing this? Sir, what is the purpose of keeping an open circuit there here in the current source and voltage source? Why are we short circuiting?
We'll be studying about network theorems in unit 2. So there, what we will do, whenever we are going to simplify a circuit, we'll be applying these rules. See, ideally, voltage source will have zero resistance. Okay, ideally, it will not have any resistance. So it is equivalent to what? Short circuit. That's why we are replacing an voltage source by short circuit. Whenever we are going to simplify the circuit, simplifying means I'm going to find the equivalent resistance, removing all the sources. So in a circuit, if you have a voltage source, if you want to remove the voltage source, you will remove it and replace it by a short circuit. In a circuit, if I'm going to have a current source, if I am going to remove the source, I'll be remove the current source and I'm going to replace it by open circuit. That is the logic. The network simplification, we'll be studying in unit 2. There, we'll be applying all these logics. For now, just remember, whenever you have an voltage source, if I am going to simplify the network, I'll be replacing the voltage source by a short or a wire. If I am going to have a current source, I'm going to leave that portion of my current source open so that no current is going to flow inside my current source. And the impedance of current source is infinity. Infinity means no current is going to be flowing. So it is just like acting like an open circuit.
Sir, but when you keep it as an open circuit or when you short circuit it, then there will be no potential difference between it.
I'm going to find
then how will a current flow, sir?
No current will flow. I'm going to find
in voltage, sir. In voltage circuit, if you replace the voltage source by a wire, then there will be no potential difference. So, no current will flow, no sir. So, what is actually the purpose?
No current flow. I'm going to find the equivalent resistance of a circuit. Just like how we use the formula resistance in series and parallel, right? So, if my network is very complicated, I cannot use KVL or KCL that easily. I will first simplify the circuit. So simplification means I'll reduce the number of resistors. So I'll be using formulas for series and parallel. So in that case, if there is an voltage source, I cannot apply those two formulas for series and parallel connection of resistors. So in that case, I'm going to replace my voltage source by short and current source by open and find the equivalent series resistance. For that purpose only, I'm going to do that. As you said, if I remove the voltage source, there will be no current flow. But my objective is not to find the current. My objective is to find the effective resistance of the circuit, which I can do it without the sources also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Another doubt, sir.
Yes.
Sir, voltage source and current source means one and the same only, no, sir? Because voltage source can also produce current. Current source
yes.
can also produce voltage. So, what is the difference, sir? Is the resistor only the difference? Or
Yes. Voltage source is predominantly available. We in turn represent voltage source by current source also by current source parallel to R. There is no separate current source available. Voltage source delivers current. So, what is the current given by this voltage source? It is Is equal to Vs by Rs, right? So I can represent it by current source parallel to resistor. So these two diagrams are almost analogous. They are analogous.
Okay, sir. Okay, understood, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now, different types of voltage source. You have first one voltage controlled voltage source. See, when you have this term controlled coming in your circuit, your voltage source diagram will no longer be circle. It will take the shape of a diamond. This indicates that the voltage source is variable. Variable means it depends on what voltage controlled voltage source. This voltage source offers a voltage which is proportional to K into V1. This V1 is voltage of some other component in the circuit. So far what we have seen, voltage source and current source are constant. They are not variable. Their value will be constant. But there are also voltage sources which are variable. They are called as voltage controlled voltage source. The voltage source means the source is voltage, but it is controlled by voltage. So the output given by this voltage source is a constant into V1. That V1 is going to be the voltage of any other node. So it is variable. If that V1 is going to change, this value is going to change. Okay? The same way, current controlled current source. So current source means you will always have a circle followed by an inside arrow mark you will have, right? But if you are going to have a diamond, it means that it is a variable current source. So, it is a variable current source and it varies depends on what? Current controlled current source. It is going to vary depend on current flowing in some other part of your circuit. I am coming to say that these types of circuits are no longer going to provide you constant voltage. The voltage or current provided by these circuits will depend on the parameters of some other elements. So, what should be the remaining two configurations you should have? I told you the two combination. What should be the remaining two combination?
Change the controlled current source, current controlled voltage.
So the remaining two are current controlled voltage source, voltage controlled current source. So I'm showing you the diagram. See whether the diagrams are logically correct. Voltage controlled current source and current controlled voltage source. So voltage controlled current source means you have to draw a current source. And the value of current source depends on voltage. Clear? Current controlled voltage source means you have to draw a voltage source and the value depends on current. So these four types of sources will also be available in your circuits. So while dealing about these variable sources, you have to be a little bit extra careful. The logic and everything is going to be same, but a little bit extra caution has to be exercised when you're going to deal with these dependent voltage sources. So these are called as dependent voltage sources or current sources. But the previous thing, the very first thing what we have seen, they are independent current sources. Independent means their value does not depend on any other circuit component. But the four sources what I have shown you here, their value depends on some other parameters of the circuit. So they are called as dependent current sources. So any doubt in these four things? Any doubt in the four types
sir,
of
yes,
you can ask.
Sir, can you please explain it again, sir?
So you are clear with voltage and current source, right? They are
yes,
going
sir.
To provide you constant value of voltage or current, but there are also types of sources where the output provided by these sources are going to be variable. So see here, voltage controlled voltage source means the circuit is a voltage source. So you have to draw an old voltage source, you will not use a circle, you will be using a diamond to indicate that this is a dependent voltage source. And voltage control means the output given by this voltage source will depend on, again, some other voltage, K into V1. See, whatever K I have used there in all the circuits are going to be constant. And the symbol adjacent to K is the actual variable quality. So V1 is somewhere present in your circuit, that V1 is going to influence the value of this voltage. That's why it is called as voltage controlled voltage source. Same way, current control current source, it is a current source basically, but it is controlled by some other current. So diamond, inside the diamond, you will be drawing an arrow mark, and it is K into I1. So I1 is current flowing through some other element. So it is going to be K into I1. Same way, you can draw the remaining two. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now, inductance in series. See, I'm not going to derive inductance in series and parallel. Inductance in series is same as what formula? It is same as looking to see the formula.
Resistance in series.
Very good. Inductance in series is same as resistance in series. Inductance in parallel is same as resistance in parallel. Capacitance in series is same as resistance in parallel. It will come reverse. Capacitance will come reverse. And capacitance in parallel is same as resistance in series. Is it clear? This derivation part, I am not going to do. You just need to know this, because whenever you are going to simplify inductance or capacitance in a circuit, you have to see whether they are series or parallel, apply the suitable formula, and you will get the value of equivalent inductor in series or inductance in parallel. Same way, capacitance in series and capacitance in parallel. The capacitance alone will be different. R and L will be, the formulas are going to be of the same format. Remember that clearly. Yes. So in next one is source transformation. So in case if my circuit is having lot of current source and only one voltage source, but it is better to convert that voltage source into current source for simplifying my circuit very easily. So if majority, assume you have 100 current source and one voltage source, so the dominating number of source are going to be current source. So that one voltage source, if I want to convert that also into current source, my analysis becomes very, very easy. So that is possible in a circuit. So I can convert a voltage source to current source. You know, for an voltage source, always you will have voltage series with RS. In current source, always you will have current series parallel with RS. So how do you relate VS and IS? And we'll go back to Ohm's law. So by Ohm's law, I can relate Vs and Is as Vs equal to Is into Rs, or from this I can find Is is going to be equal to Vs by Rs. So I can transform my sources as and when I require by using Ohm's law. Is that clear? This is called a source transformation. So I can convert from voltage source to current source. I can convert from current source to voltage source. Again, I'll be using Ohm's law only for all the purposes, because Ohm's law relates V, I, and R. Is the source transformation clear? So when will we do source transformation? If I want to make the circuit having same type of voltage or current sources. So having one type of sources makes my circuit analysis very, very easy. So should I convert only from voltage to current? Should I not convert from current to voltage? That is also possible. So I can convert from current to voltage also. So current source, you have IS parallel to RS. So I can make it as VS series with RS. By Ohm's law, I know VS equal to IS into RS. So I can convert my voltage sources as I like, depending on the circuit requirement. Any doubt in this?
Sir, can you repeat once again, source transformation?
See, generally, I have, you know, the voltage source representation is you have Vs in series with Rs, and current source, you know, it is Is in parallel with Rs. Yes, is this diagram for Vs and Is clear for you, right? Voltage source and current source. So when I need to convert from voltage source to current sources, in my circuit, if I have majority of sources to be current source and the voltage source is very less in number, in that case, if you have a circuit with fully current source or fully voltage source, I am going to feel comfortable. That is I am going to analyze my circuit very easily. So to make the voltage through all flow into current source, I'm going to do this conversion. I'm going to do this transformation. So transformation means without changing any circuit parameters, I'm going to just transform this voltage source into current source. So Vs in series with Rs, Rs can be is equivalent to what? Is in parallel with Rs. Only thing, you should clearly write what is Is. So by Ohm's law, you know I is equal to V by R, and this Is will be equal to this Vs divided by Rs.
Thank you, sir. Okay, sir.
Same way, current source to voltage source, the reverse way. So Vs equal to Ohm's law, Vs equal to Is into Rs.
Rs.
As one of your friends said, there is separately, there is no voltage or current source which you can physically see in the laboratories. You have only voltage source available. But specifically, while doing problems, you may encounter a separate current source also. So in that case, if you want to make your circuit to look even more simple, or if you want to solve it very quickly, these transformation techniques will be very, very helpful for you. Source transformation techniques, converting from voltage to current, or from current to voltage. And when you convert from voltage to current source, in voltage source, you will be using KVL, correct? If you have voltage source, you will be using KVL. When you switch over to current source, you have naturally use KCL.
KCL.
Anyway, if you are going to have a current source, I'll be using KCL. If I'm going to switch over to voltage source, I'll be using KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law. So that you should be able to clearly understand. So in the voltage source, which Kirchhoff voltage law I'm going to apply, it is very simple. If you have voltage source, you apply KVL. If you have current source, you are going to apply KCL. Is this clear?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
And if I have multiple voltage source, I can add them and make it a single voltage source. See here. See, when you have here, you see two voltage sources are in series. Correct? And see, current is flowing this way. What is the current flow inside this voltage source? Current is flowing from where to where? Inside
minus
the voltage
to plus.
Source. Minus to plus means what sign I told you should take?
Plus.
Positive.
So it is Vs. It is positive and it is plus Vs1, correct? See the second voltage source. Current is flowing from where to where?
Minus to plus.
Minus to plus means what you should take?
Minus.
Plus. So it is plus Vs2. So that's how I am going to add my voltage source. So it is clear. So if you have two voltage sources in series, I can add them and have a single voltage source. This will make your analysis very simple. See, now more number of sources you are going to have, you have a lot of confusion in your circuit. If you are able to simplify the sources, you are going to make your circuit very, very simple and clear. That is our goal. Is it clear? And two resistance we have, and the two resistance are in series, so I can write that the resistance is Rs. Rs will be equal to Rs1 plus Rs2. Vs will be equal to Vs1 plus Vs2. Is this addition of voltage sources clear?
Yes, sir.
And assume the sign is like this here. The sign of Vs2 is plus minus like this. How will the answer change?
Vs1 minus
Vs2. Vs2. Current in Vs1 is flowing from minus to plus, so I will have plus. But the current inside Vs2 is flowing from
plus to minus.
Plus to minus, so I will have minus. So it will become Vs1 minus Vs2. So now you understand why the current flowing direction is very, very important inside the voltage source. You don't give importance for the direction of current flow inside the voltage source, you may end up with wrong answers. So they always remember only one thumb rule. Inside the voltage source or inside the current source or inside the resistance, if current is flowing from minus to plus, you take the voltage as plus. If the current is flowing from plus to minus, you take the voltage as minus. So don't forget the thumb rule at all. So if I am going to have multiple voltage sources, I can simplify into a single voltage source Vs given by Vs equal to Vs1 plus or minus Vs2. Depends on the sign of Vs2. Okay, and resistance, you know, series resistance, Rs will be equal to Rs1 parallel to Rs2. Is this clear? Is this clear how to combine voltage source?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anybody,
yes,
sir. Anybody is facing difficulty? So what you should do immediately, the direction. So from the direction, you can easily say whether it is going to be additive or subtractive. Now, same way current source. I have multiple current source in parallel. So Is1 parallel to Rs1, parallel to Is2, parallel to Rs2. So how many currents are incoming?
Two.
Assume this is our node. How many currents are coming to this node?
Two, sir.
Two currents. How many current is going out?
One.
Naturally, zero. If two currents one. Come, one current has to go out, right? So, sum of incoming currents equal to sum of outgoing currents. What is sum of incoming current? IS1 plus IS2. What is sum of outgoing current? It is some other current. So, I can write I is equal to IS1 plus IS2. And two resistances are in parallel. So, what formula you apply? RS1 into RS2 divided by RS1 plus RS2. Resistance are in parallel. So I can club these two as a single current source, IS and RS, and IS will be equal to IS1 plus IS2. Is that clear? See, the current both are flowing upwards. So add. If both currents are flowing downwards, add. If one current is flowing upwards, one current is flowing downwards, so the answer is going to be IS1 minus IS2. Or IS2 minus IS1. It depends on which current is larger and which current is smaller. Is it clear direction of current source?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anybody is having... Yes. Yes. Anybody is having doubts? Yes.
No, sir.
If you have doubts, please unmute yourself and ask. These ones tomorrow's class, we'll be fully solving problems based on whatever we have studied. So these concepts, what you study till now, this combination of those should be very, very clear to you. So even slightest doubt you have, please ask, don't hesitate. Ultimately, you are going to learn and make your things comfortable, okay? So don't hesitate to ask doubt.
Sir, I have a doubt on one topic.
Yes, you can ask. Lagging leading, yes.
How I lag this problem. How to find
this problem? See, first you have to check both are cause or sign. Okay, here both are cause. So you can directly draw the diagram. Okay, always reference this x-axis. Okay. See V1, what is the angle? Minus 40. So minus 40 means you have to draw it below the reference. Clear? I1, you see the angle is plus 20. Plus 20 means where you should draw? Above the reference. So V1 is here, I is here. So what is the face angle? If you consider I as your reference, the face angle is 20 minus of minus 40, the phase angle is 60 degrees. If you consider V as your reference, the phase angle is minus 40, minus 20, it is again going to be minus 60. Is it clear? See, it all depends on which reference you are going to take for measuring your angle. So usually, whatever positive angle you take, that one will take it as a reference. So here, I should be a reference. So with respect to I, my voltage is 60 degrees. Lagging. So I is going forward, V is lagging here. That is the meaning. And one more announcement, students. So every weekend you will have a quiz. So the quiz link will be posted in your course Google Classroom page. And it will be a multiple choice question quiz, and it will be for 20 marks. So every week you will have a quiz. I'll be enabling the quiz link by Sunday. Every Sunday you will have a quiz, and that quiz will test whatever we have learned throughout the week, and that will be a multiple choice quiz. You can refer your notes, and it's going to be an open book quiz only. You can refer your notes and solve. I suggest you to solve it without referring or just typing the question in Google and solve it. So don't do that. To understand the question and solve, so it is very simple. In your Google Classroom page, you will be getting a link for the quiz. Click on the link. Click on the quiz link, and you can attempt our questions and you can submit. Once you submit, I'll be able to see your answers here, and you will be graded automatically. And these quiz questions are for your understanding only, and please do it seriously. Okay. So every weekend, Sundays, you have to take a quiz on PWE. It is going to be a multiple choice type quiz. And what will be the content of the quiz? It is going to be the topic what you have seen in the current week. Is that fine? I'll post the quiz link and I'll put it in groups so that everybody can start taking the quiz. And the quiz will be time-based. It will be automatically turned off if you don't answer within a particular time. Okay, it is based on time. So if you don't take it on a particular time, it will be automatically closing on time. Any other queries we have? I think you will be having classes continuously. Any other doubts you have?
No, sir.
Yes.
RS value in the combination of cases, the second one is
which one, series or parallel?
Parallel.
Parallel means it is parallel. Parallel means you know the formula for resistance in parallel, right? What is the formula for resistance in parallel? R1 parallel to R2 is what? R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2, right? Same way. So here only two resistances are in parallel. So RS1 parallel to RS2. Is that clear?
It's equal to 1 by RS1 plus 1 by RS2.
1 by RS will be equal to 1 by RS1 plus 1. RS2, yes. Yes, if you take LCM and reciprocate, you will get the answer as RS1 into RS2 by RS1 plus RS2. Okay. I think we'll end the meeting. Please join the other class on time. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.